It's AumSum time.
Hi guys. Can you guess the title of my next video? Hurry up! Write your guess in the comment section below.
Why does it feel so good to scratch an itch?
'Cause scratching gives us new ideas.
Oh no. When there's an allergic reaction or when insects like mosquito bite, the itch receptors of that region send itch signals to the brain. Now, as a protective response, we scratch the itch in order to remove or dislodge the insect or whatever it is on the skin that is causing the itch. In addition to this, scratching also helps reduce the itch sensation.
But how?
Scratching activates pain receptors. So, the idea is that when we scratch, the neurons in the spinal cord transfer pain signals instead of itch signals to the brain. When the pain signals reach the brain, it releases a neurotransmitter called serotonin, which is a happiness-related chemical to make us feel good and thus dull the pain. In this way, scratching an itch makes us feel good. What causes wrinkles?
A witch's potion.
Nah. Our skin consists of two important proteins called collagen and elastin. Collagen keeps our skin firm and tight, while elastin gives our skin flexibility and elasticity. It allows our skin to stretch, twist, and contract.
Just like an elastic rubber band, right?
Absolutely. But as we age, our skin produces less collagen and elastin. Hence, our skin no longer remains firm. It begins to lose elasticity. As a result, our skin droops, thus causing wrinkles. Moreover, there are some factors that can cause early wrinkling. One of them is UV radiation of the sun. Long-term exposure to UV radiation can cause collagen and elastin to break down faster than normal, thus causing wrinkles in early age. Besides this, smoking and poor nutrition may also contribute to early wrinkling. Why do we get eye bags?
It is a sign indicating that we need to take a long holiday.
No. One of the main reasons for eye bags is aging. As we age, various changes take place in our body.
Yeah, dude. I get more attractive with age.
Yeah. Now listen. Our skin contains collagen and elastin. They keep our skin firm and elastic. In addition to this, we have fat tissue surrounding our eyes for cushioning. But as we age, our skin produces less collagen and elastin, causing our skin to become loose. Also, the muscles and ligaments that hold the fat tissue in place begin to get loose and the fat starts drooping down. This loose skin and fat make the area around our eyes appear swollen, giving us eye bags. Besides this, heredity, salt intake, smoking, etc. may also contribute to the formation of eye bags. Topic: convex lens. Can a magnifying glass burn paper?
I think you have gone nuts.
No, it is possible.
What? But how?
It is because a magnifying glass is actually a convex lens. A convex lens is thicker in the middle and thinner at the edges.
Oh, like a fish?
Absolutely. This shape of the convex lens makes the parallel rays of sunlight to refract such that they converge or come together at a point.
So when they come together, do they have a party?
Oh, please listen. As the rays converge, the concentration of sunlight at that point increases, thus producing heat. This heat starts a fire, which eventually causes the paper to burn. Topic: eyes. Why do we have two eyes instead of one? You don't know? Okay, to understand this better, close your right eye. Now, are you able to see the table kept on your right side? You were not able to see it, right? Okay, let me tell you why. Both our eyes work together and help us to see, judge, and perceive a view accurately. Having two eyes provides us with a wider field of view. When both our eyes are open, we get a horizontal field of view of about 180 degrees. However, with only one eye open, we get a horizontal field of view of only around 150 degrees.
Huh?
We are unable to view around 20 to 30 degrees. Hence, we are not able to see the table when our one eye was closed.
Huh?
Hey, did you know that our eyes see the same object from a slightly different angle? You don't believe me?
Huh?
All right, look at this object. Both your eyes see the object like this.
Huh?
Now, when you see only with your left eye, the object will look like this. While, when you see only with your right eye, the object will look like this. Our eyes send these two slightly different images to the brain. The brain blends or combines both images to make a three-dimensional image of the object. Hey, but what is the use of a three-dimensional image? A three-dimensional image helps us to understand how far or how near an object is from us, facilitating better depth or distance perception. This means having two eyes enables us to judge the distance of the object or the depth at which the object is placed from us.